Hi, I'm Andrew, and I'm here to walk you through the initial setup steps for a Veritas Bevel-Down bench plane. Let's get started. I'm going to begin by taking the plane apart so that I can show you all the components. So I'm just going to pick the plane up quickly. The opening that the blade projects through, this is called the mouth, and the underside or bottom of the plane, that's known as the sole. We have the sides of the plane, and in each side is a grub screw, and the grub screws prevent the blade from skewing while you're setting it and give you a more positive adjustment. I'm going to begin by unscrewing, this is called the lever cap, and sometimes you need to use a screwdriver just to loosen this screw. Off it comes, take out the blade. So this is what's known as a double blade, and it consists of two parts. So this is the actual cutting blade or iron itself. And then attached to it, we have what's called a chip breaker. The chip breaker serves two purposes. It serves to stiffen the blade, and it also helps prevent tear out when planing cross-grain wood. This is the adjustment mechanism, which is a combined blade feed and lateral adjust. The blade rests on what's called the bed, and this entire assembly is known as the frog. And then there are three screws that are frog adjustment and locking screws. We have the knob at the front and the handle or tote at the back. Veritas planes come pretty much ready to use right out of the box, but it's a really good practice to sharpen the blade first. Now, there's probably no better way to start a debate among woodworkers than to broach sharpening as a subject. What I'm going to show you is a method that works for me, and I've had a lot of success in teaching to students over the years, but I wouldn't want to claim that it's the only way to successfully sharpen a plane blade. Really, one of the things we tend to do with sharpening is overcomplicate it, and sharpening is actually quite simple. Really, all a sharp edge is two polished surfaces meeting at an angle. The questions are, how polished and what angle? But before we get into that, I'm going to take a moment to talk about the shape of the edge. Don't have a fancy graphic, but this will serve to illustrate the point. So we have some options in terms of shaping the edge of the blade. We can sharpen it straight across, and a lot of woodworkers do this for something like a jointer plane, where you're trying to create a flat edge for something like a glue joint. We can just round the corners of the blade over slightly so that they don't dig into the work and leave what are called tracks. Or we can curve the blade or camber it, again, to help avoid leaving tracks. And in the case of something like a jack plane, that often has quite an extreme camber for removing lots of material when you're flattening a board. So I like to both camber and round the corners of the blade. And I do this because we're talking about a very minute camber, and I find that combining that with rounding the corners of the blade gives me the best chance of setting up the plane so that it doesn't leave tracks. The first step in sharpening the blade then is actually rounding the corners. So I'm just going to remove the cap iron. And I have a diamond stone here. It doesn't have to be a diamond stone that you use. I'm using a diamond stone because it has a hard surface. If you use something soft like a water stone, you're actually going to gouge the surface of your stone. So a diamond stone, a diamond plate, even a piece of plate glass or tile with some lapping film on it will work. And all we do is draw the blade along and rotate it so that we're rounding over that corner. And I'm just going to repeat that again on the opposite corner. And the reason for doing this part first, of course, is that I'm not running the risk of damaging my freshly sharpened blade. The next step is to actually establish that camber. So the blade has a 30-degree primary bevel, and then right at the tip, it's got a 35-degree secondary bevel. Because the angle of the plane bed is 45 degrees, that 35-degree secondary bevel gives enough clearance to the work. The first step is to establish the camber, and I'm going to use a 3000 grit Sigma Waterstone. That's got about a 7 micron particle size. I'm just going to install the blade in the honing guide, and I like to use a honing guide because of the accuracy and consistency that it gives me. And so I've got this set to 35 degrees. I'm just going to take the angle gauge off. So the first thing I'm going to do is establish that camber. And I'm just going to walk through it before I actually do it. What I'm going to do is apply pressure on the outside corner of the blade and take about 15 strokes. And then I'm going to switch to the opposite corner of the blade and do the same. And now what I'm going to do is concentrate pressure about halfway between the outside edge and the center of the blade so that I'm creating an even curvature. So now I'm just going to remove the swarf from the blade and the honing guide roller so that I don't contaminate my finer stone. This is an Imanishi 4000 grit stone, which has about a 3 micron particle size, so about half that of the medium grit stone. I'm just going to repeat exactly the same process. There we go. And now the blade should have a very gentle curvature to it, and that secondary bevel is polished. So now I'm going to remove the blade from the honing guide, take it out from the front so that I don't run the risk of accidentally dinging my freshly sharpened edge. And now I'm going to polish the back of the blade. So these blades are lapped flat, but they aren't polished. And so, as we said earlier, a sharp edge is simply two polished surfaces meeting at an angle. I'm paying attention to polishing the back of the blade, which needs to get as much or the same degree of polish as the bevel does. So you see I've created a medium grit scratch pattern on the back of the blade, and now I'm going to switch to my finer stone. Just get that out of the way. So as I show you the blade now, you'll notice that the entire back isn't fully polished. But what's most important is that the surface towards the cutting edge, right at the tip, is. So that's enough for us to proceed from this point. So the next step is to clear the water stones and sharpening equipment away, to reassemble the chip breaker and blade together, show you how to set up the plane, and we'll start making some shavings. So now I'm going to reinstall the chip breaker in the blade. So I'm just going to tighten the chip breaker up, ensure that it's parallel to the cutting edge. And it is, it's not going to shift. So now I'm going to reinstall the blade in the plane, being very careful to not ding my freshly sharpened cutting edge, and also to ensure that the hole in the chip breaker engages with the adjuster. Now that I've done that, I can reinstall the lever cap. I'm just going to give this screw a couple of quick turns, and I'm just going to torque the lever cap screw down. It doesn't require much force. You tighten it just until you feel resistance and then just give it a little bit more. So now I'm going to preset the blade to ensure that it's parallel with the sole. And to do that, I'm just going to pick the plane up, take a look at it, and I can see that the cutting edge is somewhat below the sole, the level of the sole. So to advance the blade, I'm going to turn the adjuster knob clockwise, just like this. And I can see that the cutting edge isn't parallel with the sole, which is what I want it to be. So I mentioned that this is a combination blade feed and lateral adjust. In order to change the lateral adjustment of the blade, the pitch, one way or the other, I simply pivot the position of that knob. And you can see that if I move it to my left, then the right-hand corner of the blade goes deeper. And of course, if I move it to my right, then the left-hand corner of the blade goes deeper. So now that the cutting edge is set level with the sole and parallel to it, I can proceed to setting the blade for a test cut. So what we're going to do is turn the adjuster knob very slightly clockwise and try to take a cut. And I'm just assessing where the blade is positioned. And it's cutting very lightly. You can see I'm just really getting fuzz. So too shallow. I'm just going to advance the blade again by turning clockwise very slightly. That was about an eighth of a turn. And I'm going to try again. Same situation, so a little bit more. So there you have it, the process of taking a bench plane through from initial setup to making shavings. I'm Andrew Strome. Thanks very much for joining us. We'll see you next time.